Hello everybody and welcome to a Let's Play Dark Souls 2 Scholar of the First Sin. I haven't had too much of a chance to play this. As you can see, I've put a few hours in, but I wouldn't consider that a lot. We're going to start a new game. If you've played Dark Souls 2 before, you'll notice there's quite a change in this version compared to the last. I was a bit skeptical of, they've just changed the placements of the enemies. How different is it going to be? But the game's actually, it will surprise you if you've played this before. If you're a newcomer, I'm a bit torn whether this is the right version to jump into, or if the original Dark Souls 2 is a better place to start. Let me try and remember the buttons. The changes, some area changes seem to be, have made the game easier, and some area changes have made the game a lot harder, so. Either way, the game's hard, so. Oh, nearly jumped off the edge there. That would have been a good start. I haven't played in a while. I am quite rusty. One piece of advice for new players, unless you're going for the Welcome to Dark Souls achievement really early, don't attack those rack-looking creatures. They're pretty weak, but they will kill you at this stage. So I'm just going to run through and collect a few of the starting items. Not that any of them are really that good. I feel like they've changed this ogre's awareness because he first time I did that he just turned around and pummeled me, so anyway, there's another item down here. I can't remember where everything is, but I remember where a couple of the things are. I'm going to skip through the cutscenes just because I've watched them too many times and I can't be bothered anymore. So we're just going to go set our name, pick a class. Can you remember your name? Yes. Keep forgetting to use the D-pad for everything. Class. My personal recommendation for new players would be a warrior, simply because you start with the shield. I've only ever played a couple of characters. I don't really do the magic characters, so I'm not sure how you would play them properly. Let's see, am I gonna challenge myself or not? I don't see what spell that is. It might be a healing one. The cleric looks alright. It's got decent strength. Very good dex. I usually go for a strength build. He's got more vit than the others. My problem is, if I start one of these, I'm just going to fall back into being a warrior anyway, so. Start with the knight. The life ring you find, human effigies you'll find, healing items you'll find. I don't remember what the petrified something is for. Let's just go with the life ring. And stick with a man. Let's make him a bit fatter like me. Face. I wouldn't spend too much time in character creation because 90% of the time you'll be covering up anyway. It's a knightly hairdo. And give him John Howard brows. And knights have beards. Let's give him a beard. Why would you have it? That doesn't look very black, does it? Give him a pink tattoo. Let's make it prominent. There we go. Everyone will know him. It's close enough to my true self.
People.
Yeah, we got weapons. Attack. Attack. It's I played a lot of this on 360. So playing this version that's actually running at 60 frames a second is quite off-putting. I know being smoother should be better, but I'll get used to it eventually. So just attack everything. If you're new, I'd recommend. Usually in Dark Souls, a mist, a fog door, they're not a good thing. The start of this game is actually training. Let's quickly do this. Target lock. Ooh, target lock. Yep. Got that from before. I'm playing on Xbox One, so for me, Y is wield two-handed. I'm doing that because a lot more damage. Backstab animations are not invulnerable anymore, so you gotta be careful when you're doing the backstab. I don't think you really collect any amazing items. What's that do? Not much. So just always be aware of your surroundings. You'll quite often get stabbed in the back. Actually, don't need that dagger. Always try and keep your oh, that's a bad time to check. Always try and keep your equipment burden down. So if you have a look down the bottom right, there it is. If you have a look down the bottom right, you can see I'm at about 40%, so my roll's relatively quick. Let me just change this around for a sec. I think if you keep it below 75%, you should be able to roll at a decent pace. Where am I going? Remember this place. If you have any smooth and silky stones, which you'll get throughout the game, if you leave them here, they'll give you items. Sometimes they're really good. Sometimes they're not so good. So they do. There's a chance to get a whip from them. That's right. Yeah, there's a chance to get a whip, and the whip's not too bad, so. Yeah, so if you keep going through these gates, they'll teach you about blocking, defending, what's next, pushing over a tree, which there's not too many places in the game you can actually use that, but we're going to move on. So if you're new to it, do the training. If you've played Dark Souls before, just keep going to Majula. I'm just going to run through here. Yeah, Majula's full of good stuff. So we're going to keep an eye out on the coast. Obviously someone's jumped off there. Can't remember exactly where it is. There it is. We're going to hug the coast for a bit. The main thing we want here is the Morning Star. Because it does less damage than this, but oops, what? 15 strength. I have to get our strength up. It's good against heavily armored opponents, which we will come across in the not too distant future. So we're just gonna keep running. Make sure you light the bonfire. I'm gonna rest, get that little bit of health back, and oh, life ring's not equipped. Resting in this actually repairs your weapons as well, so talk to the Emerald Herald. I forgot what she gave us. I think she gives you Estus Flask. So we're going to equip that. This is our main way of healing. Well, it's a replenishable way of healing. The life gems you've got to keep finding, they're a finite item. So, we'll go and talk to this depressed guy and join our first covenant. Just keep mashing A. What do you do? Oops. Learn the gesture, join his covenant. I think the way of the blue is about protection for new players. If you're wearing the ring and you get invaded, people in the blue, the Covenant of the Blue Knights, something like that, whatever the next one is, will get called into your world to help you. Of course, this all relies on people still being online and playing. There's the blacksmith who's been locked out of his workshop. You buy the key. I recommend doing that relatively quick because there's a bow in a chest in the corner here. I would recommend having a bow on you. It's good for kiting enemies. Now this is technically the only way you have to go from the start. The Forest of the Fallen Giants is, at this stage, optional, but highly recommended that you go there, level up, get some items, all that sort of stuff. I can't remember if it's in this version or not. I'm just going to quickly go down here and check. There should be a chest here, and it used to have a shield in it. There we go. Now, it's not a fantastic shield, but it is a shield nonetheless. And that's one of the ones you can counter with, so if you get your timing down, which let's just say timing's not my strong point, you can actually counter most enemies' attacks. Other items to note in here. That's an Estus flask shard, which will give us another another flask. Go and talk to the cat if you really want to. Then there's the armorer. It's usually a good idea to talk to people. Oops. While it may not look like he's got good stuff, the more you spend, the more stock he'll get. And eventually he'll have... He will give you access to certain boss armor sets. My main character's using mostly a boss armor set, so I'd recommend it. Where am I going? I'm going to go back to the Herald. Get her to give us another flask. Lands follow you all. Cool, so now we've got two. And we want to go this way. So it took me a while in my first playthrough to actually realize this is the first sort of area you should go to. I don't know. Alright, the reason I'm hitting chests, I can't exactly remember where all the mimics are. Just not with a massively overpowered weapon, but just with a weapon, I would recommend hitting every chest just once. Mimics will pretty much kill you straight away. If you hit a chest and see a health bar appear above it, there's a good chance that that's a mimic. Well, it is a mimic, and you should keep hitting it until it dies. Don't give it too much chance to come to life. Come on. So, if you've played one and not two, you'll be used to one working in sort of like a hub world, and everything's connected by shortcuts. Two isn't so much, it's more a hub and then it branches out. Everything's connected by bonfires, so every bonfire you find you can fast travel to. A lot of people weren't a massive fan of doing it this way. I didn't mind it, it made it flow quicker for me. Hey, buddy. Alright, that was bad. I did end up countering, but not because I was particularly skillful. I'm gonna try and avoid that ogre because this is one of the changes that I don't quite understand. They're pretty strong, and especially for new players. I know I struggled with them. So this shield will block most damage, but you'll get a lot of chip damage. Well, not a lot, but you will get chip damage, so... Your best bet is still to avoid rather than just about to stop everything. But it will give you a chance to stop the arrows from that archer right there. Just want to go and activate this. Because there's a high chance I'll die before I get to the next bonfire. So, things to note, bodies on the ground, not always dead. From. Those souls of the lost undead and stuff are just extra souls. So, souls is the currency in the game. You use it to level up and you use it to buy equipment, strengthen equipment, that sort of stuff. Catch is that you drop it all when you die. You have a chance to recover it, but if you die again, all of those souls are lost. So, another change to note is that depressed looking hide knight that was right in front of us isn't there anymore, so that means your chance to get the electric longsword is not here anymore. It appears like the archers either don't care or aren't there. All these bodies on the ground, well, most of them aren't dead, so they go through and hack them as they get up. Try and keep it in your control as much as possible. So try and approach them one at a time. This area is going to be a bit difficult. I'd recommend always looking around while you're attacking. Apparently they forgot to give that guy a weapon. Poor guy. Broken straight sword, not very good. Life gem. Alright, that guy's a bit annoying at the moment. Oh, that's annoying. That's a bit spastic. Be careful with your stamina while climbing up the ladder. You don't want to leave yourself with nothing in the tank. That's another thing to note. This guy is stronger than the others. He's a different kind of knight, and he wasn't there in the first one. Better than a short sword. Yep. If you'd started as another class though, that short sword I think is your next best bet. Go back down. And I can't really remember the ones that I've killed and haven't killed. There's still a few that are going to pop up. So we're gonna go this way. I think him I killed, him I didn't. Another tip for new players. If you've got the stamina, always hit that extra time just in case. You didn't have to go and kill all of them. But, it's all souls. Right. You jump in that room, there'll be a couple attack you straight away. You go around this corner, there'll be someone attack you straight away, so... whichever one you're more comfortable with. Oh. Getting a bit hacked up there. Okay. That's one thing I wasn't quite expecting. This is just a slash weapon. I usually try and use slightly bigger swords. Have a thrust attack as well. That's a bit better in these tight corridors. That's one thing I was disappointed with in Bloodborne. Is weapons just seem to go through objects. Whereas in Dark Souls, you sort of got to pay attention, otherwise you'll be bouncing off the concrete walls, and it's not good for anyone. The aggro area seems to be like they'll run off a lot quicker in this one. So I don't know if that's been adjusted or if I just never noticed it. Archer at the end. There's also a guy that's going to be throwing stuff at you. There's also a bloody archer up there. Can get you as well. Anyway. Before I go by, I'm just going to get to the next bonfire. Well, that's one thing that didn't happen in Dark Souls 2. I never remember being chased up here by him. So I'm just going to rest to get my health back. Someone's dropped a summon sign. Two things I'd recommend getting from her. The key. And the Pharos Lockstone. Why the key? Because I can't afford the Lockstone at the moment. Exhaust this lady's dialogue option until she starts repeating herself like she is now. And then once you kill the boss in this area, she'll be in Majula instead of there. No, we're a little too close. Interesting. So I could summon that guy to help me, but I don't really want to at this stage. I usually have to find a key to get in there, but I was watching a video one day and saw that you can just break the door down. I don't like how dark this place is. So that little lizard will give you supplies to upgrade your weapons with. I see at the corner of my eye, I think there's a guy that just got up. wrong? I think I'm wrong. It's just me being paranoid. There he is. I swear I got hit in the back last time I was here. I think if you can get onto this branch. Alright. Next, surprise, surprise, we're going to go after a few more items. Oh, are you joking? Stamina. Let's go with a bit of a cautious approach. Holy crap. So that dude's not usually there. I am running away. I'm definitely running away. Those turtle knights are definitely not my strong suit. So, bring the fight back into my control a little bit. They're the enemies that kind of need the Morningstar for. But apparently, I'm not strong enough to use it. Come on. Kind of wanted to get the Fire Longsword. Is he going back to? Nope, he can still see me. Is not much damage. If I was able to wield the mace, I think I could do more damage. Always forget about that attack. You would. I wonder if those guys have dropped down yet. Be careful. Now that gecko at the end can actually be killed. I would recommend, even if you had a bow, I would not attack him, because he will start aiming directly at you. Is that any better? That's one, should be 140. And I don't have enough dex to use it. 8. Who picked this character? So that's easy enough to get out of. There is another item in here. I'm pretty sure the reward is not as great as the risk. Anyway. Oh no! Stupid statue. That one's just a single attack. That's his complete attack. Don't get trapped in a corner. Can't remember exactly what it is. Oh, it's a shield. But not a very good one. Just gonna go back to the bonfire. Let's have a look. So what I personally look for, this top one here, physical damage reduction. That's the majority of what you'll be up against. It is good to have a magic reduction shield for later in the game. But at this stage, it's mostly physical, I would say. Alright, now watch me get killed by platforming. Yeah, I always forget you can go back up the ladder. It's good. Good timing, Tim. You can run with a shield up, I'm pretty sure. Coming up. So if you push forward when you're attacking, it does a different attack, so that'll get someone's shield away. I keep accidentally doing it at the wrong time. Ooh, we've nearly got enough for the lockstone. I think I'll end the first episode here, so we're about to get into the crux of the Forest of the Fallen Giants. So join me next time for episode 2, where we will hopefully have enough time to kill the boss and enter the next section. Thanks for watching.